Hello everyone, welcome back to the series of C++ tutorials. I am Deepak Nial, and in previous tutorial we have discussed about constructors and default constructors. So in this tutorial I am going to discuss about parameterized constructor. I will copy whole thing here and will make some changes accordingly, and will keep some things here. But before that, one thing I want to do, if you can see the green files here, data abstraction and default constructor that are not pushed and committed till now. So what I am going to do now, I will push and commit these things. And you can see the commands again if you have any doubt, and you can see there are four files. I do not want to add error out, so that has been removed. Now first I have made changes in data abstraction. I'm sorry, now you can see git status. Now there are three files. I will add maybe all the files together or file by file. So I want to do like this, data abstraction, and now I want to commit it, -m. Provide a small message, data abstraction demo. Similarly, if you want to check a status again, now you can see we have default constructor file that I want to commit, or before that I want to add it to staging area. You can see the status and it's green file now. Now I want to commit it, -m default constructor demo, and now I have made all the changes. I have committed the changes. Now I have to push it, and if you open my GitHub profile, you can see all the codes there. Right, I am clearing it, and I am not going to push this file right now because I have to make some changes. So let us begin. So the demo of parameterized constructor. So we have code name and year. So when you have called default constructor, it was this when you are providing it CSE N1, but you can also do this thing gradebook, and then the string course name and int here, and then assign these values inside this constructor, course name. This is similar to assigning some variables, what we are doing inside some functions. So you can see we have assigned it here, and this is required if we want some object GB2 in which you want to pass the values directly at the time of creation of object. So it could be like this mechanical, and then I want to pass year, maybe fourth year. So it is similar to previous example, but in first case what we are doing, we are calling this default constructor and it will assign CSE values here, CSE and 1. In case of second, it will assign values from here. So it will be mechanical and fourth. And we don't need these values at this moment, but if you want to keep these, you can always do. So I am removing these four functions. And what I need, I want to output these things, right? So I need one function, that is get function. So I will get the year function and course function only. So copy it from here, get function for the course and get function for the year, right? So now try to see out, or you can also copy it from here again, because I do not want to waste much time. This will be 1, this will be 2. Get course name, get year. Similarly, get course name and get year. So this is for object 1. You can directly pass the message in front of this object 1, right? And write object 2 here. Now come here, see this, compile the program again, try to compile it, and you can see there is error file now, and run it. Object 1, CSE 1, that is the default value have been assigned from here. And in the second object, it's mechanical and 4, it's assigned from parameterized constructor, right? I can also write a comment so that you don't forget it, and here I am writing parameterized constructor. So you might ask, if you have a functions like get course name or set course name, or get or set function for every variable, then why you need a constructor? So the point is, we need to constructors. If you want to assign variables or if you want to assign some values in the beginning of object creation, that's why you need this, right? Otherwise you can perform same thing. If you want to perform same thing using functions, what you have to do, you can create a gb2 object and then gb2.setCourseName, and it will be mechanical here, copy it from here, right? And similarly gb2.setYear, and then you can pass 4. So either you write this statement or you write this statement, both are equivalent, right? But before this statement you have to write this also. So you are actually writing three statements. If you have multiple variables, you have to write multiple statements. So what you can do, you can remove this and just use this statement. And in this case you are assigning some object with some values, right? So there are some more concepts attached to this constructor and functions thing, because these are looking like functions but don't have data types, but still there are some differences and similarities, and we'll discuss these in coming lectures. So till now, I think it's enough for this lecture. If you have any doubt or query, always write in the comments. I will respond back. Thank you so much.